It was early morning when Pachycephalosaurus awoke. The air was hot, dry, and still. A little way off, a couple of one-year-old males were play-fighting. Their noise disturbed the others, and slowly the rest of Pachycephalosaurus's small herd began to stir. The herd had slept in the shelter of a huge overhanging rock on the treeless hillside. It was the dry season. Soon the sun would rise higher, and even in the shadow of the rock it would be uncomfortably hot. The herd was hungry. They assembled gradually behind Pachycephalosaurus. Slowly they moved down the hillside in search of fresh vegetation and shade. Pachycephalosaurus felt restless. He was the oldest, largest, and strongest of the males. Therefore, he was the dominant male and the herd leader. This was the mating season, a time when other males would challenge his position. So far, he had always won. Pachycephalosaurus knew that one day the outcome would be different, and he would lose his herd to a younger male. Pachycephalosaurus called his herd in closer. The descent was steep, and the ground was hard and stony. A pterosaur flew low over the group. Pachycephalosaurus felt a rush of warm air from its leathery wings. He watched as it glided toward the valley. Over the green and yellow treetops, he could see the thin blue line of the river. A vast floodplain lay beyond, and the hazy line of a mountain range lay beyond that. A sudden crack of thunder frightened the herd. They bunched closer together. A lizard darted back into the rocks. The herd quickened its pace. The descent was less steep now, and the vegetation thicker. The herd stopped to feed on some bushes. Pachycephalosaurus chewed the leaves, but remained watchful. Another clap of thunder shook the valley. Pachycephalosaurus turned. To his horror, he saw another Pachycephalosaurus herd standing absolutely still, watching him. In front was a powerful male, his challenging posture unmistakable. The two males approached each other menacingly, watched by their herds. As the distance between them lessened, both males adopted a butting posture. Heads down, with backs and tails held in a stiff, straight line, they ran at each other. Their heads met with a dull thud. They retreated and charged at each other again and again. Suddenly, the other male withdrew, panting with exhaustion. Pachycephalosaurus had won. To prove his victory, Pachycephalosaurus chased the challenger and his herd into the thicket of Ketsura trees. Pachycephalosaurus was shaken, but unhurt. Pachycephalosaurus needed to get his breath back, so the herd moved slowly in the shade of the trees. The ground was covered with oval yellow Ketsura leaves. A shrew-like mammal darted out to catch a beetle, and a line of ants swarmed up the trunk of a breadfruit tree. All seemed still. The herd moved forward. Above them rose the tall, silvery bark and the lime-green canopy of sycamore trees. A sudden commotion brought the herd to a halt. Through the trees they could see two male chasmosaurus locked in battle. The horns on their great frilled heads clashed together as they pushed and swayed violently. The chasmosaurus were intent on their contest, and the herd passed unnoticed. Pachycephalosaurus grew uneasy as the day continued. A strange smell was in the air. A pair of Stenonicosaurus sprinted back and forth catching insects. They seemed unbothered. The smell grew stronger and stronger. Smoke. Pachycephalosaurus was filled with terror. The herd's territory was on a hillside, but the fire had them trapped. Panic-stricken, the herd fled deeper into the trees, heading instinctively for the river. They ran headlong through the thick undergrowth, almost trampling a Panopolosaurus as it lay clutching the ground with alarm. The smoke was all around them now, and the whole forest seemed on the move. The ground shook as a herd of triceratops charged blindly past them. Small mammals raced across the forest floor, and birds flew wildly above them. A fleet-footed Struthiomimus raced by, disappearing into the distance. The herd was beginning to tire. Pachycephalosaurus was a large animal, and not used to running so far, but terror and panic drove him. At last, the air grew clearer, and Pachycephalosaurus could breathe more easily. They were leaving the fire behind. The herd did not stop until they reached the dry, sandy land by the river. Here they drank and rested, in the cover of the tall rushes under the redwood trees. It was late afternoon before Pachycephalosaurus led his herd out along the river. The air was cooler, sun sparkled on the water. and all along the bank, turtles plopped back into the river as the herd passed. Several half-submerged crocodiles lay in the shallow water at the river's edge. Suddenly, one stood up. With a fast, zigzagging pace, he made for a clump of tall rushes. The herd stopped as the dark shape of an angry female Parasaurolophus rose from her nest. She had been sitting on her eggs. Her threatening posture and her size were too much for the crocodile. It turned back and slid quietly into the river. Pachycephalosaurus had no wish to anger the Parasaurolophus any further. He led his herd around her nest site and on through the rushes. As they rounded the next bend, there was a sudden explosion of sound. A deafening mixture of bellows, roars, and splashes filled the air. The herd came to an abrupt halt. Pachycephalosaurus looked wildly about him for the source of the noise. On the far bank of the river, a pack of dromaeosaurs had killed a carithosaurus. Quarreling among themselves, they were already tearing at their kill. Thundering toward them was a massive tyrannosaurus. It roared defiantly, hoping to scatter the dromaeosaurs and claim the carcass for itself. Pachycephalosaurus didn't hesitate a moment longer. The herd turned away from the river and ran back through the trees. The acrid smell of smoke still hung over the forest, but it seemed that they had circled around the center of the fire. The light was fading as the herd reached the rocky hillside. It had been a strange and anxious day for Pachycephalosaurus. He watched as his herd settled themselves for the night. Then, with a soft sigh, he too slept.